We're not actors or TV personalities. We're just a couple of guys who want to show you how to restore your car. Sometimes we mess up. Sometimes we consult the pros. It's never a problem. It's always a project.
This week on Autorestomod, the Minion loans out Gina's car. Vinny and Jeff test the drum brakes using a G-meter. Talk about discs, and Vinny pees a little. Ugh.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend.
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
What the? Where's the car? Where's the car?
Oh. Gina is gonna have kittens.
What? Who are you? Why are you in this car?
This car is amazing, but you're gonna need to get the brakes checked.
Regardless of that fact, who said you could drive the car?
Dylan.
Dylan who?
Dylan, that Dylan.
The Minion.
What we have in front of us is a kit to convert your front drum brakes to front disc brakes provided to us by Stainless Steel Brake Corporation.
Have you seen the Minion?
Hey, look, Jeff's joined us.
Hi, everyone. I'm gonna kill that kid. So, yeah, what we've got on the table here is the basic stainless steel brake kit. Now, these guys build everything from what you see right here all the way out to 6 and 8 piston setups. They have a ton of different brakes, but what we thought we would do is to just give you guys a look at the basics of what they sell for the Mustang. Their brake kits go from everything from early Fords, Chevrolets, Mopars, all the way out to the stuff they're putting down on the street right now.
One of the many cool things about this kit is it upgrades the 65 Mustang from having a single reservoir to a dual reservoir master cylinder. And this is just an incredible safety issue. With the single reservoir, if you get one brake line leaking, none of your brakes work. So this one separates your front and your rear brake. So if you get a leak in either the front or the rear, the other set still works.
Right, now, and that's the case with most cars 1966 on back. They use the single reservoir master cylinder. Didn't really see the need for a dual reservoir, but buddy how I do. I've had a couple of cars in the past where I've actually lost the brakes completely, had to pull the emergency brake arm because, well, the master cylinder was empty and there was nothing in the other reservoir because there wasn't one. So really important to have that. Now, what I like about this kit is it literally bolts up to a car with drum brakes. If you've got a V8 spindle setup with this brake kit that we're using here, you'll be able to bolt it up to any of those kind of cars that use that particular spindle setup. Okay, so that's how the brakes are when they come out of the box. But what we wanted to talk to you about right now is some neat products that are available for testing, which is something we're going to be doing a lot more of here in the near future using a G-Tech G-Meter. Now, this G-Meter is basically their 2004 model. We bought it a couple of years ago, well, several years ago now, to do some testing on some stuff. It works great. Now, since then, they've come out with two new models. They've got a tachometer, and they've also got a new G-Tech SS and RR. Now, the SS stands for Super Sport, and the RR stands for Road Race. So, basically, you have two different G-meters that you can get. Personally, if we were going to spend the money, we would go after the RR. The Road Race model is their upgrade. It has a lot of neat features on it. Now, RRR is a little older, and it has a little less of the features that you see in the new one. The new one has a micro SD card and a reader, so you can pop that thing right into your PC after you've made a run. And the cool thing about making runs is this. The older RR, like the one we have here, basically you had to go, if you're going to do like we're going to do today, testing 60-0 for braking, you'd have to go out, start a run like you would at the drag strip, go up to 60 miles an hour, and then stop as suddenly as you possibly could. Now, you don't have to do that. With the new RRG meter that they sell, you can actually go in and start your test at any given speed and just slam on the brakes and then do your distance testing for that. The nice thing about the G meters is this, is we're going to be using this in a lot of our different testing. As we go along with these cars, this G meter is going to be very important. For instance, on this, we're going to be able to get our 60-0 times on the 65 hardtop that you see underneath the little G meter here. So, In coming months, you're going to start seeing more and more of our ancient G-meter. But if you want one, you might want to go check them out. Now, what Vinny's going to do right now is he's going to show you a new brake bleeding system from the guys at Phoenix Systems, and then he's going to take the car out, do some driving with it, and test the drum brakes to see how well they don't work.
We've got a really cool new tool from Phoenix Systems. It's the Phoenix Injector. This is a tool that you can use for bleeding your brake systems and for bleeding your hydraulic clutch systems. And there are several features that make this tool really awesome. One of the big ones is that it allows a single person to do the brake bleeding or hydraulic clutch bleeding by themselves. And it also uses reverse fluid injection as well as bleeding. So you can actually pressurize the fluid and push it through the system instead of only having the option of bleeding it out. So the concept is you can go to each of your calipers or your wheel cylinders and actually push fluid up through the system, and because air rises, you're not having to fight the properties of the air trying to rise to the top by pushing it down. This kit comes with a bunch of different adapters, so you can use on any make model car for bleeding the brakes, even if you've got anti-lock brake systems, and you can use it on pretty much any hydraulic clutch system. So this is a really great kit to have. The drum brakes in and of themselves, back in 1965 when this car was brand new, weren't too bad. They'd get the job done for you, just your normal driving, going to and from work, to and from school, to and from the grocery store. No problem. You know, the biggest issue that we have these days is a lot of shops don't know how to deal with cars with four-wheel drum brakes, and if they don't get the brakes adjusted right, the car will really pull one way or the other. Like, watch this. I hit the brakes a little bit hard, and the car's wanting to pull to the right. And the disc brakes do give you a little bit better stopping performance. We're going to do some tests and measure the stopping distance from 60 miles an hour to 0 miles an hour. And we're going to do a comparison from the four-wheel drum brakes to doing the disc brake conversion and see how much better the car stops. It'll be fun.
Dude.
I think it's a good thing we didn't do the interior in this car yet.
Why?
I think I might have peed a little.
All right, now one of the first things you're going to want to do is to go in and actually bleed down the system. Now we're going to be using, we've got a MightyVac that I've had for a long, long time. We use the MightyVac to pull all of the stuff out of the reservoir, and the rest of it is just going to kind of drip and leak out of the tubes once we get everything disconnected up underneath the car. I'm giving Vinny the cap here. We don't want to get the brake fluid on the paint because it will actually damage the paint on your car. Take the MightyVac, hook it up, stick it down in the reservoir, and basically just pull the fluid out.
Yep, you're full, you're full.
It's kind of like a straw, you know when it's empty. All right, Vinny, you're good to go on the rest of it.
All right, first things first, we got to get these old drums off. Once you have that off, the drum should just come right off. Okay, this is pretty common on drum brakes where the shoes will just get stuck to the drum pretty well. And in order to remove them, you just have to loosen the shoes up by loosening the adjuster. In order to do that, there's a little slot on the back of the plate on the drum brake assembly, and you can get the specialty tool. It's a little spoon that's specifically made for being able to get in there and turn that adjuster. You can do it with a screwdriver, but The adjuster makes the job a lot easier, and even on more modern cars, as new as 30 years newer than this, still have drum brakes on the back, and tool's well worth the money. Much better. Okay, next we need to remove this rigid brake line. Then we've got to remove this clip. Now we're ready to pull this whole drum plate assembly off. Okay, we should just have four nuts on the back of this plate to pull off. And that whole assembly will come right out. Easiest thing we've ever done.
All right, you should always have your safety goggles, like Benny should have his on. Here's your glasses.
Thanks, I think. Oh yeah, these are sexy. All right, just one more wonderful fine threaded nut. Now, one of the bolts that holds this assembly on is a little bit longer than the other ones, and that's usually the hard one to get off. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn these wheels. And that should allow me to use a punch to knock that bolt loose. Can you see that? Did that move at all? Right here where my finger is? Yeah, let me try this again. There we go. So we went ahead and used a hammer and knocked the three shorter bolts out. That longer one really is giving us some hassle. We're just gonna keep working on it till we get it off. Success. Hey Jeff, you better come take a look at this. This is no good.
Man, every time you say that, Dick Doofus.
Oh yeah, look at that. Dick Doofus got us again.
Man, and you know the sad thing is that didn't have to happen, because if they had gone in and greased the bearings, this wouldn't be a problem. See, what happens is a lot of times is those bearings will actually get really, really hot. And when they get really hot, they'll seize to that race. And when they seize to that race, the race will actually start running around the shaft, and that's what causes that kind of a problem. That is an annealed shaft, kind of like right. What Mike talked about from Meet Detroit Spring.
Yeah.
With that situation like that, you're going to have a real issue. So, I guess I'm going to have to go to the guys over at Bob Oswald's Classic Mustang and get a set of spindles, and we'll be coming back with this next week.
Yeah, we definitely want to replace the other side, because if this side's messed up, the other side's probably equally messed up, and I just don't trust them to drive down the road.
You smell that?
What's something? What is that?
Minion!
Well, alrighty then. So, tune in next week and watch us on Autorestomod.